EYBL is widely regarded as the most prestigious summer basketball circuit in the country. When I talk to all the kids, they all want to get over there. When I talk to all the college coaches, almost all of them will say, yo, EYBL is the best spot. However, when I talk to my guys, and we got a lot of friends in common, you know, the Kamal Yards, Mar Austins, and Terrell Myers, and all the Lonnie Lowry's, all the guys on the Under Armour and Adidas circuits, they concede that people perceive the EYBL as superior. But they say that perception is a result of more or less the stagecraft and production value that Nike brings. In other words, you know, Nike really puts on a good show. They put it together. They make people feel like they're experiencing something. And then they take it a little bit further and say, it's not really a big difference in the quality of basketball on the different circuits. I want to know, what's your take? Is the basketball on the EYBL superior to that being played on the Under Armour, Adidas, and the independent circuit?
I got the gumptions to make your conjunction function. So honey, get it straight or be on your roller blades and skate. My stops was fast like a rise, then it get you itching. My flow is crisp like a bucket full of cannabis chicken. I move the beat like pottery. Lyrics flow like blood through the artery. With more rhymes and numbers in the lottery.
You know, and this is no knock on what they're saying, but I think when you look at the numbers, be it, you know, the rankings, you know, and I'm not a big ranking guy, but if you look at the draft boards, like, we can sit here and say the basketball is indifferent, but if everything is dominated by the majority, which is Nike kids, then there has to be a difference. Mm-hmm. Like, as a competitive, you want to, you know, you got to say what you got to say, and you want to believe what you want to believe, but the shit is real. Like, you know what it really boils down to. Like, you know, if we go down the list of guys that's projected in the lottery this year on the top 20 picks, the majority of those kids are going to be Nike kids. Mm-hmm. So how can we say that is an even playing field? You know, now what I will agree with, I think Nike does put on the best stage, you know, the best show out there. But part of putting on the best show is having the best talent. Like, you can create a platform, but if the talent isn't as good, you know, you're not going to get the same attendance and recognition. So to kind of counter what they're saying, is the best. And I mean, like, they wouldn't per se, other companies wouldn't be losing players to Nike every year if it wasn't the best. Mm-hmm. Now, do I think each of those programs that you named have had really good teams over the
A lot of good players. Yeah. Some pros.
Have they had pros, and have they had, but they've never consistently had dominant overall where they can say, I got 10 D1 players that's all going high major or A10 and higher. I don't know if that's the case. Like, I can't say they did or they didn't, but that's kind of like the difference. But then I think also with those other shoe companies, they become kind of top heavy. Like, they might have four really good teams, mm-hmm. and then the parity, then it drops, right? As opposed to, we'll have 40 teams, and at any place, 30 of those 40 are really, really good. You know, and it's like, if you bring a college coach on and you ask them the difference offline, because they got to say the political thing when they're talking in this space, you know, it's looked at as like, hey, we're going to look at a college basketball game when we go to the EYBL, but when we go down the street to Under Armour or one of the other circuits, it's a little more like going watching a high school game. Mm-hmm. You know, so I think that's the difference.
So if I'm a spectator and I'm in the gym and I'm looking at the two or the three and I'm comparing them, is it the level of athleticism? Is it the you seem to be saying, just, you know, okay, kids 1 through 8 are mid to high major players on your circuit, and it might be, you know, 3 or 4 on one of the other teams. Is it the size of the kids? Is it the ability to run and jump? Is it the coaching? Like, what are some of the main differences?
I don't really go on this circuit, but I would probably say is the they're I just don't think they've had, if there's a 12-man roster, I just don't think they're as deep.
Got it.
I think their rosters are top heavy, and then when you go to the bench, it's guys that probably couldn't make, I'm not going to say anybody else, they probably couldn't. The guys on their bench probably couldn't make my team. Me drop a flow. I wax it up and make it shine like I was mopping glow. So come on, baby love, let's put it on, no faking moves. Let's flip a coin on it, heads I win and tails you lose. Gotcha. Grand Poober comes with all of that because I got my game, then quarters in the laundromat. We keep it tight the way it's supposed to be. While jealous snakes say, damn, are you should have swallowed me. No doubt, because we hit them with a little of this and a little of this. A little of this. I got to be one of the baddest rappers on the planet. I'm bagging honeys and they all got bodies just like Janet. I play a safe.